अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस मैटलैब सिमुलिंक ट्यूटोरियल। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू डिजाइन लोड फ्लो एनालिसिस ऑफ IEEE 5 बस सिस्टम इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक सॉफ्टवेयर। कंसीडर द फिगर विच शोज द सिंगल लाइन डायग्राम ऑफ IEEE 5 बस सिस्टम। इट कैन बी ऑब्जर्व दैट बस 1 इज कंसीडर्ड एज स्लैक बस। In other generator as well as load is connected at bus 2, whereas all the remaining buses are load buses. We have to design the model of IEEE 5 bus system and determine the voltages at bus 2, 3, 4 and 5 using load flow analysis. Furthermore, we have to find the slack bus real and reactive power. The bus data and line data of the IEEE 5 bus system can be found on the internet. For your convenience, I have uploaded the IEEE 5 bus system data and its Simulink model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You just need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be open, which contains the IEEE 5 bus system data and its Simulink model. Now click on this button to download this folder. Now click on Start Download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Click on Open Folder to see the location of this folder. Now right click on it and click on Cut, and bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it, or create new folder, give it any name of your choice and paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on Extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the IEEE 5 bus system data and its Simulink model. Now to open it in MATLAB correctly, go to MATLAB software screen. Now go to E drive or where you have saved this folder in order to bring this folder in the MATLAB as shown here. You can see IEEE 5 bus system folder is available here. Now double click on it. You can see IEEE 5 bus system Simulink model is available here. Double click on this model to open it in the Simulink. Wait for few seconds. You can see IEEE 5 bus system model is open here. Friends, before proceeding further, I want to highlight that this model is originally developed by Professor Rodney Tain. This is the reference or link from where this model can be downloaded. Now let's start to understand how this model is designed. Look at the single line diagram of IEEE 5 bus system. It may be noted that bus 1 is considered as slack bus, having the voltage of 1.06 per unit with phase angle of 0 degree. Now come to model again. You can see this is the bus 1 which is acting as slack bus. Double click on it to see its details. You can see per unit voltage written here is 1.06 with phase angle of 0 degree. Furthermore, 10 kV is considered as base voltage. As we know that base voltage may be chosen arbitrary, therefore you may choose any other base voltage depending upon your choice, else this is also okay. Furthermore, double click on this 3-phase source block which is acting as swing bus. You can see here voltage of 10 kV is considered multiplied with 1.06 times, whereas the phase angle is 0 as shown here. Now click on load flow tab. You can see here this bus is considered as swing bus. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that bus 2 has generator as well as load is connected on it. Bus 2 has the magnitude of 1 per unit with phase angle of 0 degree. Furthermore, bus 2 is operating as PV bus having real and reactive power of 40 MW and 30 MVAR, as well as load of 20 MW and 20 MVAR respectively is also connected on it. Now come to model again. Double click on this bus 2 to see its details. You can see per unit voltage written here is 1 with phase angle of 0 degree. Furthermore, double click on this 3-phase source block. You can see here voltage of 10 kV is considered, whereas the phase angle is 0 as shown here. Now click on load flow tab. You can see here this bus is considered as PV bus, in which the real and reactive power magnitudes of PV bus are inserted according to IEEE data as shown here. Moreover, it may be noted that bus 2 has also some load values. That's why this load block is also connected here to represent the load values on bus 2. Double click on this block to see its details. You can see load values of active and reactive power are same as that of IEEE 5 bus system data. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that bus 3 is operating as load bus. Bus 3 has the magnitude of 1 per unit with phase angle of 0 degree. Furthermore, bus 3 has the load values of 45 MW and 15 MVAR. Now come to model again. Double click on this bus 3 to see its details. You can see the per unit voltage and phase angle are same as that of the IEEE data. Similarly, repeat the procedure to see how the load is inserted at bus 4 and bus 5. At this stage, you can see bus data is correctly inserted in the system. Now we need to insert the line data of the IEEE 5 bus system. In the line data, we need the resistance, reactance and line charging susceptance of the transmission lines. For this purpose, just look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 1 to bus 2 has the resistance of 0.02, reactance of 0.06, and susceptance of 0.03 respectively. Therefore, come to the model again. Double click on this transmission line block. You can see here same values of resistance, reactance and susceptance are inserted. It may be noted that this block is not available in the MATLAB Simulink library. This block is developed by the professor Rodney Tain. This is his contribution. That's why I have used this model. If you notice further, you will see there is a down arrow. It means that this block has another subsystem inside it. Therefore, click on this down arrow. You can see it has opened another page and consisting of nominal pi model, in which resistance and reactance blocks are inserted at the middle, whereas the capacitance is divided into two parts and placed both at the sending end side as well as receiving end side. Now click on this back arrow in order to come back to main model again. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to learn how to insert the line data in all other remaining transmission lines. At this stage, you can see line data is correctly inserted in the system. Now let's perform the load flow analysis of this model. For this purpose, go to this power GUI block and double click on it. Now go to tools and go to load flow settings. You can see by default maximum number of iterations, frequency, base power and PQ tolerance are mentioned here. You can change these settings if you want. However, in our case, keep this setting as it is. Now double click on this load flow tab to start the load flow analysis. Wait for few seconds. You can see a new window is appeared. This window shows the voltages and phase angles of all buses as well as power generation and load values at various buses. Now click on compute button to perform the load flow analysis of this IEEE 5 bus system. You can see it has performed the load flow analysis. Now compare the voltage magnitudes and their phase angles of all buses with the IEEE 5 bus system load flow solution. You can see all the answers are almost correct. Similarly, compare the select bus real and reactive power with the IEEE 5 bus system load flow solution. You can see both the results are correct. Now click on apply to model in order to transfer the results to the model. Now go to model again. Compare the voltage magnitudes and their phase angles of all buses with the IEEE 5 bus system load flow solution. You can see all the results are successfully transferred to the model. Friends, in this video tutorial, I have discussed how to design the load flow analysis of IEEE 5 bus system in MATLAB Simulink. By using the same strategy, the load flow analysis of any power system from small to large size can also be designed. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.